What's up, gamers? We're here to do the free preview. We're starting right away. First match.
The following contest is a tag team match set for one fall. Introducing first, from the Welsh Valleys.
Take a look at the talent in competition here. You can see exactly why the WWE Universe is so amped up for this one.
Journey for this woman, but she knows a win tonight will take her even further. Here comes the boat of WWE.
And her partner from Calgary, Alberta, Canada.
The legendary Hart family in sports entertainment. Natalya always ready to handle things inside the ring.
Competitive as of late, every duo looking to show why they run things around here.
Do we want Legend of the Power Play or Team Trugan and Natalya?
Highly competitive tag team division in WWE. Winning this match will go a long way in separating yourselves from the pack.
Depending on your decision, I might choose to book
that. Backdrop suplex.
What a high angle right across the shoulders. Sharp elbow.
Well.
Actually, may the best team win. Whoever wins, it's an automatic win.
Yeah. I'm just like, well, it depends on, like, a bunch of factors.
Bad spot for Chance!
Choke slam! Landed.
Did Tegan just hit a choke slam?
She did.
Right across the back of the neck.
She might have hit another one.
Gets the tag.
Did she hit a choke slam? Watch me do it again.
If I see the after party in this game, I'm
she sent flying into the corner. Dumping clothesline in the corner. Finds its target.
Let's give this an automatic W because we like both these teams.
Let's go.
That's our rule. That's always been our rule. If we like both the teams, we get an automatic W.
Congratulations to Life of the Party.
So, yeah, whoever wins this match, it's an automatic W.
Natalya knows exactly what she's
we
doing.
Might say it's cheating. No, it's not. If we like both the teams, our rule is it's automatic W.
In full control here. Face full of turnbuckle.
That's been our rule.
Wrist lock up
oh
the
my
top.
God.
Just caught flush.
Where was this from Life of the Party? They've never been this good in our video game. Did I just hear her talk? Or is it someone in the crowd?
It's you. Oh! Leg
sweep. Nicely done. Tag made. Tag made.
Deegan, help me.
Oh, will it be? and one.
She is still in this fight. Down low with the drop kick. Hit the rope.
Oh, what? The knees
what?
I don't know who's feeling this more, her or the crowd. There's a snapmare.
And a basement drop kick. Tough position to be caught in here.
This is just vicious, vicious arm stop. This is gonna be nasty.
Pow, leg breaker. She flips it back on her. She's going for it.
Oh, that's stupid, Kaden.
And a strong kick out in one.
These one counts are gonna get harder and harder to kick out of.
Look at that.
Oh, oh God. Oh.
What's your own partner?
Oh my God, it's falling apart. This is not life of the party.
Oh, a timely counter by Natalya. And now thrown back into the ring. This match is spilled out to the ringside area.
What is happening?
As we can see, tension's really running high now.
Yeah, this is probably through the ring, guys.
Uh-oh. And able to beat Natalya to the punch. Elbow smash.
And look at this now. Yes, applying the submission hold.
Oh, my God.
Whoa, locked in tight. Oh, almost a miraculous escape. And a side slam. Suplex comes in off the tag.
There's the crucifix, nicely done.
Submission hold applied. Rolling deathlock. Uh-oh, the end is no.
Yet.
Oh my goodness, what an impactful STO. Swinging the elbow to halt the offense. Elbow smash! Uh-oh. And a suplex for the win. She breaks the ref's count. Display for the world to see. Big form. Well delivered suplex. Able to tag her partner. Natalya clearly hoping to get the appreciation from the WWE Universe she believes she deserves.
Oh.
As she should.
Dodged it.
She's able to get the tag by the skin of her teeth.
Corner. This can't be good.
Kick! Oh, into the corner.
Oh, my God.
Escape.
What? What?
Go behind.
Jordan.
Nine. Scratching and clawing. This could be it.
This is not a rope. It's not a rope.
Rope break. Just in time.
Dragon Screw targeting the ankle.
First this.
The boat, Natalya, doing what she does best. Sharpshooter applied. And there's the save.
Veteran confidence and mind games on display from Natalya.
Tagged in. Gonna wear down their opponent. Oh, with the heel hook stretch. And the coming to the rescue. She shoots up the top rope. Dangerous thinking. Taking flight.
Whoa, what a landing.
And after that, you know things have just kicked up a notch. Pedal to the metal right now. Slowing now. These two teams have gone to war, Cole. Of course they're gonna wind up with a few battle scars.
What?
Katana's held close. Position for chance.
Try to end it. And they're still in this.
Oh,
God.
Oh! She returns the favor there.
Oh.
Ooh! Reverse.
Oh, my God. Oh, my God. He should stop. I ain't gonna try that again. Ow! Ugh! I was too like, ow!
Ugh! Chance concealing here!
That's gotta be it!
Taking aim on the arm.
And Chance going hard in the offensive again.
Getting that feeling that Katana's close to delivering a knockout.
Perfect. Bodies must be writhing in pain right now. The breaking point must be on the horizon.
But yet they continue forward, showing no desire to quit.
They're by Karen.
Putting her opponent on notice. Scooped up.
Oh, a bridge.
Just about as close as you can get.
That is firing your biggest shot, but leaving your prey left standing. Time to reload. Oh! It's been a struggle for these competitors to find an end to this match.
But the struggle's worth it. With every move you make, you feel this capacity crowd following you on that journey.
Oh, she got out of there. Each competitor showing they've done their homework.
There's a snapmare.
And she'll make the tag.
This is match is going on so long.
Holy crap.
Strong knee connects.
Natalya comes in off the tag. Boom. She's looking for the win. And the ref stops the count.
God. What is this? Crazy.
What's this main event match?
STO! Stomping down! And Natalya getting it taken to her in a major way.
Natalya has
to be sensing things slipping away.
What the fuck? Who timed that so bad? That's that McDavid is recording to figure out what he did.
This should be a good one here. See what bad for their opponent. Oh, wow. She sent to the outside.
Why? Please, someone win. Someone pass out.
Big impact off the net breaker. Look at this creativity applied with the wrist clutch lever, and painful as well.
Eight.
Oh, should have won by count out.
Damn! The WWE Universe won these superstars. And that's it. Scores a win for the team.
All that for a count out win.
A big loss after that count out. This match ending by count out is not satisfying to the WWE Universe. I think they may demand a rematch.
You only have six matches. We have to use one of our rematch clauses on this.
Oh, God, we're in the beginning, man.
Don't we get two of these?
Oh, God, yeah, we get two. You know what, since this is the beginning, we get two. Because, like, I don't want to waste the rematch clause when there's five matches that I don't know what it's going to be.
Man. So, do you want to move on and take the W, or do you want to keep going? Or are you going to rematch it because of the count out?
I would say we keep going.
You know what? Fuck it. It's the first match. Who fucking cares?
Yeah, it's the first match. It lasted long enough.
Yeah, it wasn't like there was a count out in like 2 minutes.
Yeah.
It's... whatever. Whatever. Let's move on. Maybe the next match will be better.
Here comes Jimmy Uso, the glue that holds the bloodline together.
That's actually accurate. That's true.
Uso!
Steel cage match, but I made sure to do the custom match so it doesn't have to be escaping. It's pinfall submission.
California, weighing in at 251 pounds, Jimmy Uso!
Jimmy Uso may be an expert tag team wrestler, but he's still a certified threat, even without his brother Jay at his side.
I actually originally looked at Tegan Knox and Natalya winning, so it worked out. It sucks with that count out, but who cares? It's a shocker for the audience. That's what matters. And it was a long match.
Honestly, guys, Jimmy Uso is the complete package.
Welcome back, AJ Styles.
Set up, Michael. A phenomenal resume, phenomenal skills, and without a doubt, a phenomenal
opponent representing the OC from Gainesville, Georgia.
Are you sure he represents OC?
218 pounds. The phenomenal AJ Styles.
AJ Styles has a trophy case filled with titles.
Oh, here's the system.
Grand Slam champion. This man is jumping on, and he has absolutely no fear.
There's one thing we've learned all throughout the years, and that's do not bet.
Let's go, AJ. Who are you going with?
Let's go.
Steel cage, no escape. You must win by pinfall or submission.
An infamously unforgiving
Hopefully this is better than our ladies steel cage last week, which ended in a dud.
Yeah, you can just sense the danger in the air.
I also, well, we had both. We had steel cage and a Hell in a Cell match.
Crush a hamstring.
I think the men will do better. I have high hopes that the men will do better in this.
Uh-oh. Looking for the suplex.
Uh-oh.
Oh, no. Great agility.
Screw that, AJ. Joking.
Painful. Really? I did.
Oh, wait. Well, one for one, by the way. Technically.
What a neck breaker.
Will we get a perfect card? Find out.
Down with
oh, let's fall asleep.
Wake
up!
And he easily stops the ref's count.
Frankly, he should have known that wasn't enough. When you're in a steel cage, there's not exactly a lot of real estate to play with, which is why you have
let's
to know
go.
How to use the cage
AJ.
To your advantage, because otherwise, it is saving us from having to sit through that.
Gotta find a way to get out of this.
Big eyes!
Good golly!
Oh, catapulting down on the opponent!
Jimmy Uso hurting a little here.
No, he's hurting a lot. Throw him in the cage.
Saw that
damn
one
it.
Coming! Took advantage!
Samoan drop!
Float over!
Uso!
Here it comes! Nicely done.
Rapid fire Samoan drop.
Counter from AJ Styles.
Using the elbow to escape the attack.
Looking worse for wear in the corner now. Left-edge chop echoing through the arena.
Okay, one thing I want for WWE 2K24, which is coming out in March of next year, they need to fix some of this jankiness. There are times where it looks super janky and unhuman. And they don't, like, move very smooth sometimes.
Moonsault.
Very good.
Into the DDT.
Styles looking for it, and he's got it. Calf crusher.
Oh, he rarely does this. The calf crusher.
Ooh, that hurt.
Jimmy Uso with a well-timed shot.
Basement drop kick.
Jimmy
yeah,
Uso
keep calling. Keep doing
the
ring.
Yeah,
actually, the emotes are bad because that gives you a charge up.
Drop kick finds the spot.
Whenever you taunt, it gives you like free moves. Or something, it gives you like extra energy or something. I don't know what it
does. Got him set up in the corner of the ring.
Come on, counter.
He catches Jimmy with a counter.
Right. Oh, fuck.
All
right, let's go.
And he's able to
cross. Not easy.
In full control here. Face first in the turnbuckle. Comes right the jaw.
I don't need a team. I'm going to do it by myself.
That's how you stop your opponent.
Some wound just went, pin him!
First a knife edge chop and now continuing the attack on the knee.
No, it's a wound now?
A counter by Styles. Face first lethal combination. This is it. Kick it.
Oh, if he didn't kick out of that, I would have been like, are you shitting me?
Fighting back with a counter. And the cover for the win!
No!
There's a survivor.
No!
A steel cage match.
No! You won like that?
Jimmy Uso!
throw the cards out the window unless we use one of our rematch cards. We got two of them. That sucked.
All by AJ Styles' effort tonight.
Well, I mean, he tried.
Damn. Got you.
All right, how do you feel about this match? Move on or rematch? Fuck!
Like, all right, the second match will be better. It won't be complicated at all. Oh, well, yeah.
He won, like, stupidy. She won, like, a stupid way, too. He didn't win... normal. I mean, we only have six matches and we start early.
Yeah, we can go back later.
Fuck yeah, I'm rematching it. I don't care. Yeah. We still have one left.
Like, I'm just like, I don't want to waste it now. Like, we're in match two.
Yep, yeah, I don't like how that ended.
Me either, but I'm just like, what the fuck? First match ended in fucking DQ. Then it ended on some weird ass finish. It's just you and your it's like I blinked in the match.
Nobody out.
Like, oh.
Speedy pinfall there.
Actually, you know what? It's the Christmas spirit. We get three rematch clauses.
Three rematch clauses this Christmas.
We get an extra one because it's Christmas. Because, yes, that's what we do. We get an extra one because it's Christmas. Does that sound fine? That way there, in case more go wrong, we actually have two extra ones.
Yeah, it's Christmas.
It's the Christmas spirit. We need extra ones.
Yeah.
I swear to God, it happens again! I swear to God.
The winner. Jimmy Uso!
Yikes, that'll either wake you up or knock you out.
Come on, Jimmy's not this good.
Come on. Oh my God.
Oh, he gave me what I wanted.
Interference much less a factor when inside the cage. What is victory?
Uso?
But it's who wants it more. With nowhere to hide, this match is going to come down to who's able to take more punishment.
When was AJ a jobber? Because this game's changed like
3 months ago.
You can't fight. Just look at Jimmy gain the momentum in this one. Jimmy displaying a lot of intensity.
I can't tell if the game like glitched out like a couple seconds ago because he was down on the ground and he immediately got up. Like no animation, it's just boom.
Hammering down on the knee.
Like Dark Side
Zone? Kick finds the mark. Oh, big time strength with the German. The damage he's taking is starting to pile up. Oh my gosh, what impact.
Watch this end in DQ. A Roman Reigns comes in and spears him in his thigh.
Well, he goes right through the cage.
This is Uso's perseverance getting tested.
Another calf pressure.
Submission. It's locked in. Tap, tap, tap. I'm not. Are you kidding me? Elbow. What a counter.
Super kick.
Stops. Elbow drop. Jimmy gets intercepted. Dangerous position with your feet tied up like that. Ah, he's got that boot right up against his face. Ooh. Handle him.
Uh-oh.
Oh, what a counter. That'll do some serious damage. Styles taking him by surprise. Uh-oh. Russell, can he take
He reversed his finisher. God.
And down with the suplex. He's in a little bit of trouble now.
When Styles gets on the attack like that, you don't want none.
Okay, he's taped it.
Oh my God!
Denied via a wicked punch to the stomach. Ooh, avoided the attack with a nasty chop block. Oh! A striking blow.
What?
He's determined to make it to the top of the cage here, guys.
Oh God.
I think he can still climb the cage.
Here we go. He's headed up the cage. No way.
What?
There we go.
Ended with that.
Two count.
Okay. All right. That's better. That's better. End it with a finishing move, not a 1, 2, 3. Yay! I mean, did you see that, Jay? Yeah, I did. Oops. I saw it.
Why wasn't that the first time? Why couldn't the game do that the first time? So annoying. We just wasted our time.
It's going to be lights out earlier than usual tonight in the Uso Penitentiary.
How is it worse? Bad start. I'm moving on.
AJ doing the
that doesn't
slamming.
Give you that full star. Come on.
No. No, but Jimmy was just slamming him and pinning him. That's memorable. Who did this? Vince McMahon? Pass every single one of them.
First time booking Shayna Baszler in a while.
She's a feared MMA grappler who is always ready to fight. The following contest is an Extreme Rules match.
I hope the tag team between Shayna Baszler and Zoe Stark go really well next week.
In her eye.
Michael, I think you
oh, she faced in this one-on-one Extreme Rules.
Baszler is ready to subdue any and all opposition she encounters.
Baszler just absolutely loves combat in any form. You say that like it's a bad thing.
Prepare yourselves. This is not for the weak of heart. Expert joint
Raquel Rodriguez, a massive presence.
And from Rio Grande Valley, Texas.
Where is she?
Raquel Rodriguez!
She took time off for an undisclosed reason.
Oh, okay. I might.
But she's better now. So.
I was like, where the hell is she?
You can bet Raquel has some more fur.
I was like, wait a minute, I haven't seen her forever.
They finally wrote her off, is what happened.
Okay.
They didn't write her off on screen. She'll be back soon, though. She seems to be better now.
Okay.
Look at her physique. Look at the size of her back.
Well, Raquel Rodriguez also has a great personality, even though every time I ask, she won't share the workout tips with me.
That's okay, Saxton. You couldn't survive Raquel's warm-up.
All right.
We're about to learn a lot about what makes them tick in this Extreme Rules match.
These matches
I have to go with him.
What the
like
fucking Dragon Ball punch is that?
They never thought they'd become.
Or you could say this match reveals a superstar's true colors, Saxton. That's far more likely.
Yeah, Raquel's the power punch. So yeah.
Why is Shayna going crazy?
Man, face buster.
Just a perfect mix of pure power and bad intentions.
Rules match.
Baseball bat.
The toys under the ring. She set her on the baseball bat. Remind everyone.
She's channeling her
inner
Liv.
Given the notice qualification modifier on this match, Corey, what kind of tactics should you expect to see here?
ruthless tactics, Cole. Now is the time for these superstars to unleash their pent-up aggression and be as violent as they want. There's nothing the ref can do about it.
I might go with Sonya, actually.
Oh, man, right to the arm. Hyperextend your elbow. Oh, jeez. That offense taking a toll on her.
Sit straight into the barricade.
You're gonna get me bet. And I'm gonna beat your ass with it. Not W yet. Oh God. Not in front of the crowd.
On the outside, look out.
She'll come back. She'll come back from this. Yeah, she'll totally come back.
Oh, this is not good at
this.
All. The pendulum back.
Yeah.
Stretch.
Yeah, I think she's got it. Yeah, I totally think she's got this. Yeah, totally. Yeah, she's super has this. Yeah, totally. Yeah, totally. Yeah, she's totally got this.
Raquel there remains an intimidating presence no matter how far into this match we go.
I'll just leave it at this.
Yeah,
nobody
really
comes into a match hoping to get chucked around like that.
There we go, see?
Go, you sure?
Saying not today.
No, see, she's
scouted.
No, see, she's got it now. That's how we got this.
Get slammed down.
Close line.
It's I got him gifts.
What do you lay?
Yeah, I bought him some gifts for the holidays.
Throws her back in from ringside.
For those of you who don't know, I got some Liv merch.
Yep.
And he got me stuff for my
holidays.
Yeah, stylist.
This battle rages on. Oh, nice hip toss. Right into a drop. The elbow of the arm. Uh-oh. Stop right to the arm. Break an arm. And Raquel looks staggered after that. Trapping the leg here.
I never heard anyone call her Raquel.
At this submission,
Raquel Rose Reggae's
locked in deep. Quite the predicament for her hair, but she's able to slip through and reverse the move. Oh! Oh! Look at that go!
Get out of the way, ref! Jesus Christ!
Where's a superstar finding this?
Oh God! Oh no!
Time for the twisting centaur.
I had faith in. She wasn't going to a match next week. I'm sorry.
You might be fucked.
She slips outside.
No, she wants a chair.
Come on, not the chair. And back into the ring she goes.
Right here.
Stuffing the chair between the top and middle rope.
It might be over for you. Take on that bomb. She's got two of them stocked up. It's over for you, Tom.
Oh my God, no. No.
You should have gone with Raquel.
I should have. You're right. I should have. I had hope in Shayna. Well, I do something, but I guess it's not my holiday. It's not my holiday. It's very not.
This sort of win shakes up.
I'm still perfect, and you get your first L.
I am not. Damn you. Why?
Never underestimate Raquel.
You're right. It's not that I underestimate her. I thought Shayna would do better. And I am disappointed. Damn it. need to team up with Sonya.
If it was Zoe and Shayna in a tag match, I would have been like, yes.
Yes.
But it was That's not what happened.
It's like, nah, Shayna's good. And she got her ass beat for like 2 minutes. Never.
That's how I do things.
The dawn of WWE has arrived.
It's Captain Gabagoo.
The following is scheduled for 1-4, making his way to the ring from Chicago, Illinois, weighing in at 240 pounds, Tony D'Angelo.
Soprano.
Tony D'Angelo is not playing games. This is a man who's been through it all. He survived the turf wars and paid the price to be the Don.
How do we make it? No,
here's the gambler, Andre Chase. I'm going with Andre Chase. Who would you want?
I am going with Chase. I don't care about Captain Gabagoo. I'm sorry.
Captain Gabagoo.
And if I'm understanding this right, this it's
remember, guys, it's not pinfall submission. They gotta knock him out.
Chase is a true student of the game, Cole. His methods may be unorthodox, but he likes to find the teachable moments where he can and develop his talent accordingly.
Well, he sounds like a blowhard, but to each their own, I guess.
Forget about it.
Look, you definitely have to be on your toes.
It's gonna turn to South. No, it's gonna turn to Family Guy, like Italian racism jokes.
Stars don't matter. It's not gonna happen at any point.
Yeah. Bob the Boopy. Like they're just gonna turn to that. I'm like, man, fuck it.
D'Angelo is absolutely breaking his opponent down. He's feeling the effects of that last hit.
Luckily, he has got the butt shake.
Still swinging. Looking for a high risk move. High risk. Another fake with an elbow drop.
Come on, you're like the principal or whatever, right? What is he? Is he just a teacher?
Yeah.
Okay, who's the principal?
To change the complexion of this match.
Shawn Michaels?
I guess that was a good
one.
Yeah, that actually makes sense. Can this knock someone out?
Submissions don't knock people out unless it's a sleeper hold.
I'm like, how'd you get knocked out from that? He had a fucking stroke. He got knocked unconscious.
I think Tane's at a disadvantage because he has moves that are like submission type stuff.
Yeah. Chase U just hits him with the dollar bill.
Good golly.
Going right after
golly,
the
neckbreaker.
Carefully stalking their opponent.
Hey, you have some money I can
borrow? Boom, basement drop kick.
If he's busted open, does that count as knockout?
No.
He has to be literally knocked out.
He has to literally be knocked unconscious.
And it looks like he
so he has to hit him in the head really hard.
Napping. A page right out of the Chase U textbook. Talk about a teachable moment.
Sorry, I'll give you my gambling test. I swear, I'll pay off next week, man. I swear I'll pay off. Please don't kill me.
Fisherman Buster goes into the pin. Two.
Wait, who wins my kickball?
Then boom. No one got. No one's teeth flew out. No one got knocked unconscious. No one pissed himself. It sucks.
Counters. This could be an opportunity. Fist.
Sleeper! This will knock someone out! This counts! Don't they go unconscious? before he got hit with a weird stunner. Oh god. Oh no. Oh no. Oh, don't do it. Gabagoo! It knocked him out! It knocked him out!
Here is your winner, Tony D'Angelo!
Fuck Chase U. Just shit school. I hate their policies. Not teaching them how to wrestle.
Well, I guess it's we move on. I will take the L on that one. So, I guess we're both not perfect anymore. But we could be only one loss. It's not bad. Five for six.
That's okay. I'll take the two. It's okay. I'll take the two losses. 4 out of 6 ain't bad.
Just for the way it ended, it was kind of unique. I had to move on. I was like, I can't rematch that. Oh, this doesn't fit at all.
A young lady who likes to fight.
Look at me, my skateboard!
I'm burning!
The following contest is scheduled for 1 fall, making her way to the ring from Chicago, Illinois, Cora
Sting!
This is building off the past 2 weeks. This is the rubber match. Because of something that happened last week in our Hell in a Cell match.
Yes.
So this will be our rubber match because it's tied 1-1. But who will face Cora? Who will get the revenge on Cora?
If Cora wins tonight, maybe she'll do some skating after the match.
Or maybe she'll crack that skateboard over your back.
It's going to be one of two people. It's going to be Liv or Roxanne. Oh, I just spoiled it.
Wait, come in. It was the right thing.
Elmwood Park, New Jersey, Liv Morgan!
Liv Morgan, a little unorthodox, a little unusual.
All right, guys, this is going to be a first for video game Liv. She's going to be in a 10-minute time limit match where you must win in 10 minutes. If you do not win in 10 minutes, it will be a draw. The odds of that being a draw is slim to nil. So this will be fun because now they're on the clock. Doing the welcome home chance again.
Sentimental favorite among the WWE universe, the very confident Liv Morgan.
Liv likes to say, watch me, as in, watch me prove you wrong, watch me overcome. This is someone who spent her early career as someone else's backup, but now she's in the spotlight and we get to watch her shine.
Maybe we'll watch her win tonight as well.
Is she going to be a Shining Wizard?
Side of the ring is Cora Jade.
Dying Wizard.
Time and time again, just key. How tough she really is.
Guillotine!
Guillotine choke.
Fighting desperately.
I'm kidding.
Shrug off her opponent. Forearm.
Kick to the gut. Right go long into a neck breaker.
She's done. Look at this one, Liv.
And that'll be a rope break right there.
Chop block.
Brilliant. Right to the back of the knee.
Why is Liv not doing it?
Jade is heading up top.
What the fuck is. What is Cora Jade on?
Oh my god! They're treating him like a jobber!
What the fuck is this?
Welcome back!
This is supposed to be the fucking bar match and it's turning into a disaster.
Underestimating her.
Some people still see Liv as the perpetual undercover!
Don't cover, please.
The undercover!
And she gets the shoulders up. She probably didn't expect it to put her away there.
Smack herself in the face?
Yeah. Get a
team. I don't know how Liv would do this in real life, just because she hates Roman Reigns.
Spear! Flip Morgan spear.
Oh my god. Could you imagine Liv with a spear?
Oh my god, she does a spear.
She's starting to look concerned. She can withstand the punishment, though.
Yes, Liv can.
Cora Jade taking a moment to let the crowd really appreciate her.
Why'd you get scared, Liv? That was weird.
Oh, man, by the
hair. Oh, no. It wasn't the higher distance that caused the damage.
I don't want to do that.
Oh, no. Crashing hard onto the floor. You have daring. You have stupid.
That was almost pulled like an AEW.
I actually agree with Corey Graves. That was pretty stupid.
Yeah, no, stupid.
Stupid. Stupid. Stupid.
The scissor.
It's like, okay.
Head scissors.
Stupid. Stupid.
Puncher.
Executed hip toss. Not the prettiest thing you ever seen.
That was a good reason to celebrate.
Yay!
I don't.
Wait!
He's fighting ghosts. She's got him.
<out. laughs> She's fighting. Wait, what happened? I missed it.
She fucked ghosts.
And then, like, ghosts.
Yeah, she fucked ghosts. That's the only explanation I have. Up, without her legs.
Realize every lick is fucking crazy.
Oh, blocked it. Oh, no, Viv, no, Viv.
That's not a reason to celebrate.
No, oh, God. No. How is Toby now?
And she's not done yet. This isn't even close to over.
This is the nuts. This is the most way better than the first match.
She missed. What the fuck is this? This is match.
It is better than the first match.
It is. By a long shot. Oh god, I know she's planning.
No way.
Okay, she hit her then.
Absolutely throwing all caution to the wind.
Spinning in the face of danger.
She's starting to drag a little bit.
Liv not afraid to bring the fight to her or anyone who gets in her way.
I hate the sit down mat slam. She does that way too much.
What are you doing? No, she froze.
Why'd she freeze?
I don't know. She's doing shit. No, I can't. I can't release my lip.
Gotta find a way back in the ring now.
I can't. I can barely control it.
She'll counter. I have faith. Or not.
Oh no.
Using the rope to their advantage.
Attacking the arm.
Places her right in the corner. Marching up the corner.
What was that, Cora?
What
that says, do not mess with me because I will respond.
On the top.
Kick out, but resiliency popped.
Liv Morgan showed what she's made of there with a really impressive kick out. A big opportunity falling through their fingers. You've got to continue fighting and hope your next big move is the last one. Liv is losing any kind of advantage here. Good strategy against Liv Morgan, trying to press the advantage and...
No! Why would you waste it there? That is not a reason to celebrate!
Yeah, I did! I did my go breaker! Yay! Alright, now! Die!
Oh!
I don't care how much magic you put on the floor. The AI is
watching!
After that miss.
Just pop comeback. Just pop comeback. What are you doing, Liv? Just pop the comeback. At this point, you need a comeback.
It's been a hard-hitting affair here tonight.
These competitors are going to have trouble walking on their own after this one.
I don't think I've seen them do that.
What are they doing here?
Just fucking pop your comeback.
There's that.
Oh my fucking god. I just realized I have 2.5 minutes to get it ready.
No,
yes, he is here,
letting the opposition know exactly what's on her mind.
You just need to pop this fucking comeback.
That was nice.
At this point.
Go right to the kidneys.
Oh, finally a counter. Is she gonna do Firecracker?
Knife edge chop.
No, a knife edge chop.
This competitor has such a deep arsenal.
What?
What? This could be it. For the win.
What?
Somehow won off that.
A new move that Liv has never done before. She won off of. That is a first. That was a new move I've never seen her pull off.
This is what it's all about.
And she won with it.
She pulled off a new move, and Cora Jade was so stunned she couldn't kick out of it.
And it was better than the last match.
What a weird match.
And then Liv saw ghosts randomly.
And Cora was like, at the air. It's like, what the fuck?
Liv saw
ghosts. I saw ghosts.
And that's how she won.
They helped me.
She helped. No, isn't Liv into like witchcraft or something?
I don't know.
She used her witchcraft to win.
Oh, it's a ghost.
She makes these ghosts.
Like, thanks for your help. What was it? The team that cursed the belts?
The Unholy Union.
Yeah.
The Unholy Union was behind the ghost.
Thank you for helping me make my comeback. Using the ghosts of the damned. I really appreciate that. Thank you. I even got to use my new move.
Yeah, that new move.
Yeah, I won off it. It was great. She never saw it coming.
She pulled off two new moves in this. What the hell is this match? Let's move on. Oh my god.
Congratulations, Liv.
Tom, Team Liv and Roxanne have done it. It's over. The feud's done.
Feud's over.
Thank God. Liv can move on to someone else. Oh my God.
Our next opponent will be Nia Jax. No. No.
God, that would be like a fucking April Fool's joke.
One of the most entertaining teams in WWE history. Angelo Dawkins, Montez Ford, the Street Profits. Two of the toughest tag team competitors around.
I want the Street Profits. I don't care who they're facing. I want the Street Profits.
Hell in a Cell.
We want smoke.
And at a combined weight of 492 pounds, Montez Ford and Dawkins, the Street Profits!
Triple Crown Tag Team Champions, NXT Raw and SmackDown!
You know what that means, Michael? It doesn't matter what the brand is, the Street Profits.
I got a feeling this match is gonna be too sweet!
You should never do that again, because these two are Japanese legends continuing a legacy in WWE.
I've seen them forever.
I actually think the time of music with the pyro perfectly.
We don't need AJ.
And
we don't need him.
At a combined weight of 505 pounds. And Luke Gallows, the OC!
You know you are in for an all-out fight facing the OC. Two men with a hot...
I know Hell in Cell will be long, so.
Yeah.
Oh, they want Street Profits too. They agree.
And I hope you guys bought the smoke, because someone's about to get it from the Street Profits.
All right, here's our main event.
Montez Ford and Edge.
Oh!
You guys have a rusty confidence level on 100. It's easy to see why. It's been a long time since we've
had a team. Will we get anyone climbing the cage like with the ladies one last week? Or will we get nothing?
They say some people were made for this industry.
Maybe the OC's more likely to slam someone through the cage.
And remember, we're going tornado style here tonight, which means we won't see any tags in this one. Everybody's leaving. There's an uppercut. That's the uppercut.
We want to trample. Bang! Uh-oh. Alley-oop! Boom! Uppercut. That's a knock, you silly.
Oh, man, they do not care who.
The table.
Table.
Dangerously close to being collateral damage in this one. Punch. Oh, man. Oh, jarring uppercut. Yeah. Boom. And look at that turn back on him. And that was a precisely measured attack.
Liv got turned back on him.
This match grinded him down a little.
I swear to God, I heard the commentary say Liv. I don't know. I thought I heard Liv. I swear, I don't know if I just heard that. I think he just said it got turned back on him, but it sounded like it got turned back on Liv. I'm like, did I hear that right? Liv were gonna change gender. And became black, I guess.
Big punch finds its mark.
This is a clusterfuck. What is this?
Resign themselves to the fact that doing battle in this torturous structure means their mind, body, and soul will never be the same again.
Fishing for something, but
counters and look.
The steel chair never as innocent as it looks. Bear, he's taking some good hits.
I can't see what's going on.
Back into the ring.
The table is not even used, it's just sitting there.
So impactful.
What is going on? I'm not following with the action. It looks like ants. It looks like I'm in the balcony. I'm putting some items at OC.
He certainly has to be piecing together a new game plan now. Atomic drop!
When was there a chair?
Has
to carry this match.
He's with the gun stop. That can put Dawkins down for good. There's two. And a kick out. Another one. Saw that coming. How close was that?
That was about as close as it could get without it all being over for him. And there needs to be a refocus now. That was the moment that could have ended things. A moment that's being replayed in their heads right now. He may be in a bad
way.
And this is
Fucking boggles up when you hit a chair with one, and they call that move variety.
How's that move variety? We've seen this thing.
It's a deep launch. And what this again move we just saw there. As close to three as you could possibly get without the bell ringing. A calculating look has come across Paul's face. Stopped dead in their tracks with a shot to the face. These two showing how well scouted they each are.
Cheers. Shot after shot.
Ruthless striking. Any more hits in that area could leave him dizzy.
Look at this. Just stop after stop after stop.
No one's trying to pay.
Damage on the way here.
Everyone needs to come out. Including us.
He's looking for an implement of destruction under the ring.
Isn't that like shooting in the ring? Cage?
There's no reason. This is not even
on a song.
There's a set.
That's lame.
This is
that was the lamest match ever. Why was this
here are your winners.
Then?
Carl Anderson and Luke Gallows.
We got three of these, so we have to use our last rematch clause. I'm not accepting that. I don't accept that kind of outcome, especially when they pinned them and there was no finisher used.
We say it time and time again, but the Street Profits really are a team that love to have fun. They love to get the party going, have a good time. True, but don't get it twisted, Cole. Ford and Dawkins' high energy can translate into some absolute intensity when they really get going.
This was our last rematch, but I swung it out, so whatever happens, happens.
And at the risk of sounding morose, following the
first elimination,
one of these superstars will
this is our last match, though, so I have to burn it.
Face first with a waist lock takedown.
We used it on AJ Styles, Liv Morgan, and this match.
The third one was a Christmas gift.
Use the cell to your advantage.
Yep, we have to use our Christmas gift on this main event.
Last Christmas, I gave you a match.
They didn't even do anything with that cell. They did nothing.
Very last day. He botched it away.
Kick to the gut.
The fuck?
Left. Now he's been
put save your boy.
You'll be lucky if this is the worst he suffers in the set. Great reversal. Carl gets jolted by the count.
Montez is soloing.
Now the outside, right by those cell walls. Heads out and he has all the time he wants. Side of the ring now.
What's the plan here?
Well, at least what I can see them from here. Oh, God.
Close fist connects.
That's like we're in the opposite land. Now Montez Ford's kicking ass, and Angelo Dawkins is being weird.
This match's brutality starting to show on him. This is what Hell in a Cell is all about. You have to be able to endure this kind of punishment when you want the victory. Claw to the face.
There's
no issue with that attack. Hey, sometimes desperate times call for desperate measures. Who are we to judge? Oh my God, DDT!
I think that's an insane little thing.
Yeah. some damage already.
Hoist it up.
Suplex. Vertical suplex. Toss down. Oh no, getting in position. What's he planning to do here? Abdominal stretch. It's locked in. We're going to find an escape from the abdominal stretch.
No, you're not getting through that. That's not. No. Come on.
This one is headed outside, guys. Caught with a punch. And it's reverse pain for that mistake. Double impact.
I don't know who's winning. I think the Street Profits are.
No clue what he hopes to find out there.
The sound of this crowd is deafening, and he's asking for more.
Landing the uppercut.
Oh, stiff uppercut.
And he goes into the ring. Oh,
that'll rally him. And he has to start protecting himself from attacks to that area.
AI is such.
He's got four here.
Oh, the ref just got fucking rocked.
Who did it?
I don't know. The refs are conscious.
A lot has been endured by Angelo Dawkins, and he could be done very soon. I want to walk it off or shake it off or do whatever he needs to do to get his head in the game here.
A bat.
He deflects it with a bat. Short clothesline hits its mark.
I am not probably. I don't think she's probably the block at all.
No, that's a three.
He didn't kick him.
This started as a match. Now it's a test of will. And Carl finds himself behind again.
Dawkins with an outstanding surge at exactly the right time.
Counter. Out of the ring and into hell itself. Big time power slam. I'll tell you, this guy's no competitor here. He's looking to give in. It's going to take a lot.
Taking flight.
Body splash. Right in front of the victory. And it just reverses.
He got it. A career changing win inside hell in a cell.
Here are your winners. Carl Anderson and Luke Gallows, the OC!
Alright guys, peace out, it's gone. We were out of our best clauses. We go, I went 4-for-6, Tom went 3-for-6, and he went 50% failed. I barely passed. Alright guys, peace out.